want to get on and do kayaking and canoeing. This is the opportunity we've been looking for a long time. On Tiger River, remember we heard last month, I guess it was Jim, you reported having so many problems with, you know, access to the river. We didn't want to get it for whatever reason. This opens up from, you know, Clifton all the way down to the Packet River, and anybody can get on it. It's just a phenomenal opportunity. The company came to us because they could put this property. They came to us very quietly. Dr. George Fields got involved and through his group, and I think they kind of secured it. It's been several months ago, maybe early in the year. And we asked them to hold it for us because we really wanted to have the opportunity to get this. And this is going to be a great place. And that slab was built so they could go up when they built the mill. We don't have to do a whole lot to it, actually. I mean, you can put some picnic tables, campground, you know, whatever. You got 35, 40 acres, it's pretty clear. It's just a tremendous, I think, opportunity for us. And I would encourage the committee to give it a favorable reading.
After being co-chair of the Tourism Action Plan, I can assure you this is a premier piece of property that we do want to invest in. But I will also allude to the fact that I'm very cautious when it comes to mill sites, having dealt with the Victor Mill project. You can say what you want to and know everybody's got the best heart at stake, but until you get those soil samples, you don't know what we're dealing with. I don't see a water tower. Is there no water tower on that piece of property?
Great word of caution, Jane. O'Neill, y'all knew you and I had to call you. Had your hand up. Go ahead.
Mr. Chairman, if I can, there's two or three things. One, I'd like to, number one, I've talked to Jim about this, make sure there's no underground storage oil tanks or whatever there. Your study will show it, should Spartanburg County want to get rid of the property, what it would cost to remove the concrete, that's going to be part of it. I can assure you that all environmental studies is going to be done, including the silt behind the dam, what it costs to remove the dam. You may want to, in your resolution, I've had it pointed out to me, and you may want to put the physical address in there of the property. And you may want to go in there and put behind the site, or you know, where we might have a possibility of just buying a portion of it. And then right at the end, you may want to add the word exploratory funded. And I believe you told me that the match was going to be $15,000 to get this grant. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
I just suggest before we voted on this, maybe if y'all would concur that we add that language, adding the physical address where it says redevelopment of 5299 Clifton Glendale Road, the former Clifton number 2 mill site. And then in put in there, or a portion of thereof into the public parks. And then down at the end where it says initial project, just put track project and put exploratory funding. Might clean that resolution up a little bit.
At least if the committee decided to give us a favorable vote, would it be more proper to change as per the desires at the full vote of the council for general session?
Yes, sir. Mr. Chairman, just to make you aware, we are presently speaking with the owners of the mill. The county attorney and myself have looked at, in fact, they have presented us a letter of credit. As council will remember, we came up with the ordinance after the Victor Mill situation require either a performance bond or a letter of credit be put in place so that we wouldn't get tied up with the cost of cleaning up the mess if somebody walked away. So John and I have been dealing with the property owners. We have sent the documents to the bank and making sure that we get our letter of credit for that cost. The first phase of it is the warehouse portion that is going to be torn down. They have already had the environmental reports on it. I do have copies of those have been furnished to me as far as the asbestos reports and things like that. The second phase would be later on down the road would be the mill
and that would actually be a separate permitting process once they start taking that bill down. It's all, so you'll understand that one. But we're trying to cover our bases from a building standpoint to make sure we're covered in case something happens, like the Victor Mill project.
Yes, one of the things that I was concerned about is knowing that environmentals are going to have to continue to be done. We want to make sure we're all clear as to who is going to foot the cost of those environmentals. Whether Spartanburg County buys it or not, environmentals are going to have to be done, or whoever buys the piece of property. So let's make sure the right people are responsible for that.
Debbie, if you would, if we have a break, work with Dale on that, I don't know.